गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम मेनका शुक्ला। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टीच यू इंग्लिश लिटरेचर गुलमोहर फॉर स्टैंडर्ड 3, सेकेंड चैप्टर काकू एंड लाल हवा। नाउ आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन दिस चैप्टर, सो स्टूडेंट्स प्लीज बी केयरफुल एंड लिसन इट वेरी नाइसली। काकू लिव इन ए स्मॉल विलेज कॉल्ड छोटी ददी। Every day, Kaku had to walk to his school. He loved the long walk to school because he had made a new friend on his way. No one knew why he loved walking past the green paddy fields, the village lake and the old ground to reach school. No one knew Kaku's little big secret on the way to school, not even Amma. Now students, in first para, I'm going to explain you. Here, Kaku. Who is Kaku? Kaku is a small boy who lived in a small village called Choti Dadi. Kaku always walked to school. He loved the long walk to school. Why? Because he made a friend. On his way. That's why he always go to school by walking. No one knew why he loved walking. It means that no one knew that why he go to school by walking. He never use rickshaw, auto, van. He never go with it. He always love to go to school by walking. The village lake and old ground to reach school. No one knew Kaku's little big secret on the way to school, not even Amma. Here, in this line, his Amma and other people did not know the secret of Kaku, that why he went to school by walking. Second para, every morning, Kaku would be ready in his school uniform, eagerly waiting for his tiffin box. As soon as he got his tiffin box, he would run out of the house to meet his friend Lal Hawa. Here, in this second para, every morning, Kaku ready for school, he wear his school uniform like you. You also come to school and for coming school, just ready. Was ready and for you in your school uniform. And here Kaku eagerly means very determination with that he eagerly waiting for his tiffin. When he got the tiffin, he ran out to the house to meet his friend. Who is his friend? Lal Hawa. Now in third para, as he crossed the paddy field, soft chuk chuk sound greeted Kaku. First of all, students, I will explain you about Lal Hawa. What is the meaning of Lal Hawa and what is Lal Hawa? Here in the new words, Lal Hawa, in Hindi, the word Lal means red and Hawa means wind. But the Lal Hawa is also the name of the train. In the picture it is shown. The name of the train is Lal Hawa and the name of the boy is Kaku. This is story about Kaku and its Lal Hawa. Third para, as he crossed the paddy field, soft chuk chuk sound greeted Kaku. He was happiest when he heard Lal Hawa coming. He always got the best view of Lal Hawa from the top of a small mud hill near the village lake. Kaku knew just the place when the speeding Lal Hawa would whistle. He believed Lal Hawa said hello in its language. When it whistled, Kaku whistled back, welcoming Lal Hawa. In third para, as he crossed the paddy field means field where rice is grown. The soft chuk chuk greeted Kaku. The Lal Hawa come and its sound is when the train run you heard about the sound its sound chuk chuk that sound greeted kaku he was very happy when he heard the sound of lal hawa he always got the best view of lal hawa from the top of the small mud hill near the village when the lal hawa come he always went to the top of the hill top of a small mud hill near the village to see the lal hawa to take got a view of lal hawa kaku knew just the place where the speeding lal hawa would whistle he believed lal hawa said when the lal hawa whistled he believed that the lal hawa was saying him hello in its language means when the lal hawa whistled kaku thought that he greeted him as hello and in the return kaku also whistled back welcoming lal hawa here standing on the small hill kaku saw lal hawa become bigger and bigger in second lal hawa covered the whole blue sky as it chugged forward kaku jumped with joy chugged means made loud noises while moving slowly made loud noise when moving slowly here standing on the small hill when kaku was standing on the small hill he saw that lal hawa is coming when he saw from far it looked very small when as it come near it looked bigger and bigger you know children when we see anything from far it looks small but when it comes near to you it so bigger like that lal hawa is also from far it looks small when lal hawa come towards kaku it's so bigger and it also covered whole sky with whole sky as chugged for lal hawa covered the whole blue sky as it chugged forward kaku jumped with joy when he saw the lal hawa he feel very happy and he jumped with joy now come to the second page number 10 now students he clapped and waved as lal hawa chuk chuk passed him when lal hawa passed he clapped and waved him waved means say like this the hand we say as his eyes followed its magical wheels he saw a small hand waving to him well his eyes followed a magical wheel that magical wheel he saw a small hand waving to him he ran along with lal hawa waving back at the small hands kaku ran along with lal hawa and he also in return he also waving with his small hand like this kaku loved meeting lal hawa every day he liked its red paint its fast moving wheels and chuk chuk sound it make as it moved every night he pray for lal hawa to stop at his village just once in this para kaku loved to meet lal hawa he is very very crazy about lal hawa he regularly every day he loved to meet lal hawa he liked his red paint its fast moving wheels and chuk chuk sound also made by the lal hawa every night kaku pray from god that please god let lal hawa stop to his village at once only once a time lal hawa stopped to his village from the god he pray one day kaku asks his school teacher why doesn't lal hawa stop at choti dadi sir one day kaku asked from his teacher his school teacher that sir why doesn't lal hawa does not stop at choti dadi then his teacher replied kaku our village is too small for the mighty lal hawa His teacher replied that Kaku our village is too small means very small for the mighty Lal Hawa. Here the mighty means strong and powerful. That Lal Hawa means, Lal Hawa means the train was very powerful, very strong and powerful. That's why it doesn't stop our village. Kaku was sad. His Amma gently consoled him by saying, the meaning of consoled is comforted him when he was sad. Don't be sad, Kaku. I'm sure Lal Hawa will stop here one day. But Lal Hawa never stopped. Every day it raced past the village lake, leaving Kaku alone on the small mud hill. Here in this para, Kaku was very sad. Kaku feels sad. His Amma gently consoled him by saying, don't be sad, Kaku. Here in this para, Amma consoled. Consolement assured him that, don't worry, don't be sad, Kaku. I am sure that Lal Hawa will stop one day. Lal Hawa will stop one day in our village. So please don't be sad. But Lal Hawa never stopped. Every day it raced past the village. But the Lal Hawa never stopped in his village. He raced past from the village, and Kaku, as usual, alone, standing alone on the small mud hill. Here, the Lal Hawa never stopped in his village. It passed from that village lake, and as usual, Kaku always stand alone on the small mud hill. Now, next para, a few days later, Kaku reached the small hill as usual. He could see Lal Hawa approaching. Kaku closed his eyes and started praying that his dear friend would stop. His eyes were closed, but he wondered why his ears could not hear the chuk-chuk of Lal Hawa. Startled, he opened his eyes. There, right in front of him, Lal Hawa had stopped. Kaku could not believe it. Now, in this para, few days later, means after some day, Kaku reached the small hill as usual. Means, as usual, regularly he reached that small hill to see Lal Hawa. And Lal Hawa approaching, when Lal Hawa approaching means coming towards to Kaku, Kaku closed his eyes and start praying from God. Start praying from God. What he wants to pray? What he is praying? He is praying that, please God, let the Lal Hawa stop in his village. He wants that Lal Hawa stop in his village. So that he pray from God to stop the Lal Hawa in his village. His eyes were closed. When the Lal Hawa coming towards the Kaku, he closed his eyes. What he wondered why his ears could not hear. In this line, the meaning of this line is, wondered means surprised. He closed his eyes, but he not hear the sound of Lal Hawa, that chuk chuk sound. You know, children, when the train runs, the sound comes chuk chuk. That sound is not heard Kaku. That's why he surprised. Startled means he shocked or alarmed. Startled, he opened his eyes. He shocked when he not heard the sound of Lal Hawa. He surprised, he shocked. Why I'm not listening the sound of Lal Hawa? Then he opened his eyes. What he see? What the Kaku saw? Kaku saw that in front of him the Lal Hawa had stopped. Lal Hawa had stopped in his village. He was very surprised, children, that his desire was come true, that the Lal Hawa stopped in his village. Kaku could not believe it. Kaku is very surprised. He not believing that Lal Hawa had stopped in his village. So then he heard a noise coming from the village. Then he heard a noise. Noise means halla. Coming from the village. Everyone was running towards Lal Hawa. There, everyone coming towards Lal Hawa. Who is coming to Lal Hawa with shouting and cheering? His Amma, his school teacher, his friends, and his and the old retired railway guard hurrying towards. In this para, then when he heard a noise coming from the village, everyone was running towards Lal Hawa. Everyone coming towards Lal Hawa. And with shouting and cheering, means very happily they come towards the Lal Hawa. And who is that person? His mother, Amma, his school teacher, his friends, and the old retired railway guard coming towards Lal Hawa. Lal Hawa had stopped at Choti Dadi and was waiting to meet Kaku. Lal Hawa had stopped in his village and waiting for meet. To whom he waiting for meet? Kaku. Kaku. Now student, come to page number 11. Lal Hawa whistled aloud and Kaku laughed and whistled back. Here Lal Hawa whistled loud. Aloud means loudly. And in reply, Kaku also laughed and whistled back. Quickly he climbed onto Lal Hawa. And just then Lal Hawa chuk again. Here in this line, with joy, with happiness, Kaku climbed onto Lal Hawa. And then Lal Hawa again start. The chuk chuk sound become faster and soon Lal Hawa was flying on magic wheels. The chuk chuk sound comes again, become faster. My faster means great. And soon Lal Hawa was flying on magic wheels. And he run very fastly as flying on magic wheels with Kaku in it. Amma smiled. She had tears in her eyes. From a window, Kaku waved to everyone. Lal Hawa was flying and so was Kaku. Here, Amma smiled, Amma laughed. And in her eyes, there are tears of happiness that Lal Hawa stopped in his village. And he saw from window that Kaku waved to everyone. Kaku waved means, again I say about waved, means haath hilana, like this. Wave to everyone. Lal Hawa was flying and so was Kaku. Understand children? Here the summary of the lesson is that this lesson is about Lal Hawa, the train, and the small boy Kaku, who lived in a small village. His wish come true. His wish was that Lal Hawa once a time stopped in his village, and his wish come true. Once a time Lal Hawa stopped in his village. So students, I have explained this lesson. You have to read this lesson and understand line by line. So please listen my video very carefully. And this chapter Kaku and Lal Hawa is written by Anubhav Yadav. Here is a new words and given in your books. Just note down in your copy and learn it. Here some lines are written about Anubhav Yadav. Anubhav Yadav teaches at the Delhi University. She is also a writer and filmmaker. She writes for children and adults, and her work has been published in many books. So children, please read this lesson and listen my video also and try to understand whole lesson. Now come to the text. Here text A is given. Number the sentence in this correct order. The meaning of this question is, there is a sentence A to J. You have to mention this sentence. Sorry, you have to number this sentence. Which come first, which come second, which sentence come in third number, which sentence come in fourth number. Like this you have to mention. Only first one is done for you. Kaku lived in a small village called Choti Dadi. This sentence is number one. Like this you have to do all. And last, number 10 is, Kaku climbed onto Lal Hawa and soon they were flying together. Understand? And last you have listened that when Lal Hawa stopped in his village, Kaku onto the Lal Hawa and they flying together. Like this you have to do all. Number the sentence from 2 to 9 because 1 and 10 is done for you. Now come to page number 12. Page number 12, there is an answer this question. This answer this question I will done for you and give on Tenu. Please see on Tenu. So students, rest of the exercise B is here. This is very easy. Just try to do yourself. And number C is given here. Complete this sentence with suitable word from the box. I have numbering this. So please say it very nicely. Would you like something to eat? Yes, I would like just a little rice, please. Here little is second one, third, four, five, six, seven. Seven sentences is there. If you are able to do, please do. Otherwise, I will send on Tenu. Now, please, students, read this lesson and try to do exercise in which you are able to do. Thank you, students.